Good evening to all. We are back with our next session of Avantika Connect, brought to you by Avantika University. So I'm just waiting. The participants are joining in. So I will just wait for a couple of seconds and then I will start. Yeah. More and more people are joining in. So give me 2 seconds more. Yes, I think we are good to go now. Well, welcome you all again, once again. This session is brought to you by Avantika University under its program, which is known as Avantika Connect. As you all know, Avantika is a design-centered university, one of the pioneer in design education in India, with lot of creative thinking, alignment on liberal arts, and all those stuff. The academic program of Avantika are led by DICE, which stands for Design, Innovation, Creativity, and Enterprise, with interdisciplinary curriculum and experiential learning at the core. The students are offered interesting courses like critical and creative thinking, creative visualization, design methods, and science of nature. The university is based out of Ujjain, Madhya Pradesh, and I'll take 1 minute of yours in telling the importance of Ujjain. As you all are aware that India used to be the forerunner in education system of the world 5,000 years back from now. This region was known as Avanti, the Avanti kingdom, and its capital used to be Avantika. Later name is Ujjaini, and now it is known as Ujjain. The city is located on the banks of River Shipra, and Ujjain played an important role in the education landscape of ancient India, as it fostered linguistic, astronomy, arithmetic, classical art, and liberal thinking. I should also mention here that Ujjain is the city of great poet Kalidasa and Guru's Guru Sandipani. Okay, so before I introduce you to our speaker today, let me, as a format of this session, let me ask you a couple of questions which will also attract a gift voucher. Fine. So here I am with my set of 2 questions. How many heuristics are there in user experience or in UX? The participants have to answer through the chat board or the question and answer session, which is there on your screen. So I am repeating the question. Yeah, I'm starting getting the responses also. So how many heuristics are there in UX? This is my first question. Okay. Yes, we are getting the response. Okay, I'll come to the next question. Name the fashion brand by Deepika Padukone. The next question for a gift voucher is, name the fashion brand by Deepika Padukone. Okay, I'm getting the responses. Some of them are right, some of them are wrong. Fine, we will get back to the winners after the lockdown is over. Fine. So I also want to share with all of you a wonderful news which has come across to us quite recently, which is that our student Sahil Jain has been selected to be a part of YDC core team. Now, what is YDC? YDC is Young Designer Circle Network, and this comes straight from the World Design Organization. So congratulations, Sahil. Congratulations to his mentors, his parents, his faculties. Now, I think I should come directly to our speaker. I will briefly mention something about him. And he is none other than Shri Rajiv Mishra Ji, who is the principal of Sir J.J. College of Architecture, Mumbai. He is an architect and urban planner based out of Mumbai, a graduate of architecture from Academy of Architecture. He undertook postgraduate studies in town and country planning at Government College of Engineering at Pune. His special interests are issues dealing with sustainable urbanism, community architecture, heritage conservation, and technology in building management. He has taught for 27 years and has been involved in conducting seminars and workshops on subject of architecture design, city planning, history and theory of architecture, as well as on development of urban management at Sir J.J. College of Architecture. He has been the chairperson for the course committee of interior design and is currently board of studies chairperson in art education at University of Mumbai. He has involved with IIT Mumbai for the first solar passive architecture education handbook. So without taking much of your time, directly to Sir Rajiv Mishra ji, over to you, sir.
Thank you, Amit ji, for a very nice introduction. It's a great pleasure to be invited by the Avantika University. I will try to make a difference. I will try to first welcome all the participants who have come on the screen to listen to me about design, design education, and the subject as a transforming tool. Design is a much popular misunderstood subject, and a lot of people think that they are designers irrespective of the qualification they have received. But it has been a great pleasure to let you know that designers, to the truth of their personality and sense, can actually cause a difference and become agents of change. Today, what I would do is I would begin my presentation first by showing you a small slideshow. And I would like all the participants to know that since I am an architect, designer, and an urban planner, most of my presentation will deal with issues related to design, but it will not be able to cover fashion design as a subject. It will talk about communication design, tools that are used for communicating design, but it will not talk about drawing in design. Today, I will try to make all of you realize the value of a designer and how you, if becoming or on the way to become a designer, can become a very important citizen for changing this entire world. Currently, we are going through tremendous situation of pandemic, but I'll tell you, it is the designer which now will be able to learn to design better public spaces, better hospitals, better facilities for a good hygienic environment so that it can take care of the entire city while people live in them. It is something that designer learns over a period of time, and design is an evolving process. Design is something people love to do because they enjoy solving problems. And designer is actually looking forward to various facets of problems which he would love to solve. So any designer who says that I'm in a problem, I don't know what to do, is actually not a designer. But I guess we will come more to question and answer session after we have completed my presentation and I have had my point made. So just give me a minute to share my screen so that we can start. Thank you, Amit. Can you see my screen? Hello?
No, it's not visible right now, sir.
Ajay, I'm trying to share my screen. Yeah, I just share my screen. Just give me a minute.
Sure, sir. Sure, sir. Yeah, it's visible now, sir.
Are we ready, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I think I would begin by showing you some of the most beautiful design products or projects or anything that you might say that you would be able to be in a position to appreciate. So I guess you are looking at industrial exhibition site that was inaugurated in 1853 under the Gusave Eiffel Tower, which was the first attempt at industrial design for creating an industrial exhibition. The second image that you are seeing is, of course, a magnificent car, which actually draws you towards it for provoking you to drive it. The third image that you see is, of course, the Sydney Opera House, which actually represents the most important building in a city called Sydney. And it brings in about 30% of the revenue for that city. You can see a shoe, but shoe designers are not well known. But I guess the comfort for a feet involves shoe designer to design such shoes. And of course, who does not know an iPhone, which actually has blended technology to the art of telecommunicating with people the right way, the bright way. So all these are inspiration of design. You may look at them very casually, but you must know that they have come out of a designed thought. So today, what my objective would be, you know, to just let you know the factors that has caused architecture and design style to move in a certain direction. There is architecture of life. There is architecture of everything that we do. And it is this design that puts in a very important wheel for it to move in a certain direction. So we basically are going to look at the effect of design first on society and then the effect of society on design currently. We are also going to talk about comprehension of the role of the nature and the fact that man is one of its part. We will assess briefly the role of designer and then we'll try to obtain an idea on the possibilities and levels of sharing design styles. But this is something that you have to understand that it will cover product design, communication design, industrial design as we go on. So these are the three factors which cannot live without each other. If you think that design can be done without understanding its function and technology, you cannot design. And if you think technology has to use design, then it has to be for a particular function. You might have realized that, you know, a few years ago, the washing machines were looking like an industrial product because they were designed by manufacturing companies to deliver the reason for washing clothes. But then later on, when washing machines were designed for people, they decided to do them better. The washing machine suddenly had to be pleasing to the eye. So we will do this. We'll take up design as a subject, look at what happens in society, its impact. We'll look at the designer. What is he trying to do? Create a brand image and then become a brand by themselves. And then let's see what happens to the man who manufactures and becomes the producer of all the designed products. And you who wish to do design or want to become designer ought to know this. So first, let's see what society wants from design and what is it that the society has been demanding. So society has been demanding the use of technology, the use of form that it wants to see that causes a great pleasure to the eye for it to look beautiful. So what you see are the expensive projects that you can imagine. The Dubai building, the Sydney Opera House building, the interior spaces of a mall are all desires. Can you see a Walkman, Sony Walkman? And it was for, let me tell you, a time when people wanted musing to be in their pockets and they wanted to walk with it. And that's how Walkman was designed, to bring in music. We will see later the latest version of Walkman and how Walkman became an old designed product. So this is what the design on society and society on design has been looking forward to. The next slide that you actually see is the demands of the society on design. Society wants maximum number of apartments, and therefore the buildings that you see are the kinds of building that you see in a skyline, which do not look very beautiful, but they fulfill the demand of the people of getting to live in small houses, because everybody wants to live in cities. Can you see a nano car at the right hand bottom? They want small cars, and therefore nano had to be designed to accommodate the desire of the society. Maruti 800 ambassador cars, one for the sake of economy, the cheapest car, and one for the sake of comfort. So these cars were actually earlier designed to bring in comfort. They did not bother to see how ambassador car was good to look at or bad to look at, as long as it provided the comfort. So it was something that we had to go through over a period of time in the past. So I show you the slide again. Design on society, society on design. Let's go further and see how nature has been an inspiration. The power of existence takes you to a new level. Power of nature first tells you to appreciate life, understand beauty, which is a contrast. See the powerful imagery all around the world, and then makes you humble. To be able to design planes that actually looks or imagines the flight of a bird. Wants you to design a car that is actually going to fly on the road. Wants you to design a building over falling waters, and therefore the building is called Falling Waters. And therefore the honeybee crunches or the honeybee houses or shell-like structure becomes an inspiration for a designer. Now the designer comes up with a better car. He comes up with a better understanding. He does not design ambassador cars and Maruti cars or nano cars. He learns that if people want to appreciate art and if they want something pleasing to the eye, he has no choice but to design better vehicles. By the way, the highest paid designer all over the world today is an automobile designer. He's the highest paid designer today as a professional. But if you were to look at the understanding of design, which is nothing but a symbol, or it goes by symbolism, you have to understand that it looks at three things: function, the impact it has on the human mind, and the quality or reliability of its product. So unless it is for the public benefit, unless it brings delight, and unless it creates a brand, an image that you would like to be part of, design would not be successful. So you may be a very good designer. You may come out with the most beautiful design product. But if you are not able to bring impact, and if you're not able to bring delight, your design solution needs a better option. And this is what the gambit of design is: explaining the benefits of design to the producer who's going to manufacture it. Otherwise, your design product will not see the light of the day. Let's see some case studies. So I think this car, it broke new ground because it became the most beautiful car to be in. We'll see it why. You see a building called the Bilbao Museum in Spain, which actually broke all tradition, which took one step ahead for people to know what it is for. These were progressive designs where you will find why an iPod that converted music and changed Walkman's position of it in the industry to a small item in a pocket. So Apple iPod actually became something so efficient that it could actually bring music in such a small portion of a designed product. It gives direction to the brand. It became a very efficient machine and it gave a good user interface. It brought in all songs. It gave you better music. And therefore, this design product, which you can call it as an industrial design, became the most successful brand. The iPhone basically was well known for creating an interface between what it could convert one item to another item. And therefore, all the sizes that you see and all the challenges that the technology could bring in, iPhone was successful to implement it. The entire success was then related to Mac. And today, Mac is the most important brand that actually brings in the maximum designer thoughts with its software being supported in it. Now we see this car, where this car was actually designed only for targeting customers of its own kind. They came up with radical design, and you could actually move this car by not being in it. Your design looked not only good from inside, but you actually had a key, a magnetic key that could drive cars from outside. So it's a designed car for which you don't have to be going into it. You could stand outside from a parking lot and drive your car without driving it in front of you wherever you are standing outside a lobby. So I think if technology is exploited through design in a way that it not only becomes comfortable, but it also brings in joy, then you have become a very successful designer. After having gone through such case studies, I guess let's see a very successful project done by an architect called Frank Gehry, who designed Bilbao Museum in a sleepy industrial town called Bilbao in Spain, which was a dying town. This town had no economy and the entire economy was dying. This museum that was now or is even today bringing in the contemporary art of Spain was inaugurated by the King of Spain, only to get all the people from the world to come here to see out of curiosity and also bring in not only jobs, but also a lot of delight to the city. The entire city economy grew just by a designed building by an architect. So the impact of designer is so high that it can change the economy of a place. It can turn a dead city into a live one. So the design that you actually see here is done with a new element, a new product of material that was unknown to the people then. It used computer-aided design. It used computer-aided engineering. It used computer-aided manufacturing and brought in multiple dimensions and blended all kinds of professions. But the designer was the main person to organize it, to take a direction and see what it did to a dying city. Some more projects designed by the same architect. So you not only design buildings, but you also design products. You design chairs, you design chains, you design watches. So designer is a person who basically understands the needs of his client, needs of the user, gives him something so sensational that it not only helps him get what he wants, but also makes him proud to have this brand, not only to show it around, but to be strong enough to prove that he can not only afford it, but also get or attract the right designer who can actually translate their minds. So in architecture, we basically 5 years of design education teach the following design aspects. The basic design covers the arts and craft. Interior design covers the interior spaces and how to deal with them inside the building. The landscape and the site design takes care of the site on which the building stands. Urban design talks about the city and the spaces that are interconnected. And this is what is related to the current pandemic. The urban design of cities in our country were never done to a level where congestion was reduced. All unhygienic conditions that you see in cities are responsible for the spread of any disease, not only COVID, Corona, but any. In the other aspect of design, you have the following subjects you can choose from. They are independent subjects of industrial, interior, communication, transport design. I think all transport terminuses, all metro stations are part of a very good design projects because they become a very important landmark building and they only become a place of reference for people to remember from. I think the fashion design is something that I will not be able to cover in this presentation, but how you yourself look at things from inside is also important from how people look at you from outside. And I think fashion design covers and brings in not only the personality, adds color, but also make people look at each other with appreciation, with positive mind. So here, I am just trying to show you a sketch where if you can see that you are the essence of the being in the center, and if you become a designer, and if you try to design some project, you are in the white zone. In this white zone, you will get people who will send you negative energy, okay? There will be people who will also send you positive energy. But you as a being should try to see that you let in only positives inside you, okay? You should also get positives of the society inside you. And your essence of being should be able to do a design product which is going to be appreciated by all the people so that you can spread positivity all around the world. So you are supposed to be here in the center. So remember, if you want to be a designer, you're going to face a lot of issues, a lot of advices. But if your essence of the being is clear that this is what you want to do and bring in change, or cause change, nobody should be able to stop you. So in the world where quantity is respected more, it is the quality which suffers. So you as architects, designers can play a very important part. And whatever you design as a possession is much more valuable than quantity. One good design product will stay forever in life. So remember, it's your quality and not your materialistic aspect. So a designer spends more time on quality of a product than making quantities of it and suffering from it. Believe in yourself if you want to become a designer, because the happiest people don't have the best of everything. They just make the best of everything that they have. Be simple, just be yourself. Do not be influenced. Just be caring. And just leave it to somebody else. If you are not able to do things your way, don't do it. You are not under any obligation to do it. And I want you to succeed in life because no matter what happens to you, there is everyone who has got a design intent or quality in everybody's heart. Is somebody using it to a greater extent? Somebody is using it to a lesser extent. So no matter whether you do engineering, architecture, fine arts, what you need to do is come to a conclusion, take a position, and to be able to design. And that designer is very important. So people who design buildings are called architects, okay? People who design interiors are called interior designers, and so on. So I guess you ought to know the last thing that I want you to be very clear, that anybody who plays a central role in the development of anything is a designer, is the architect, okay? So I would always say that Subhash Chandra Bose was architect of the military movement in this country. Mahatma Gandhi was the architect of the freedom movement in this country. Jawaharlal Nehru was the architect of the development in this country, and so on. So every time you play a major role, you are a designer. You are the one who started it. You are the one who put in the seed and let the seed grow. I wish you all the best. I want you to succeed. I am now ready for your questions and answers. Thank you very much for your attention.
It was very insightful, sir. Thank you very much for your words of wisdom too. In fact, I have received many comments which are praising the information which you have shared with them, specifically on the car designing, the Bentley one.
Yeah.
Sir, I am taking a question from one of the attendees before I will be putting few questions from my side, which I have jotted down. Yes, because this question seems to be very relevant. And Ganesha KS is asking, is there any scope for ambassador-like products to have redesign and capture market again?
See, ambassador cars were basically designed for Indian conditions and Indian roads. And it was more designed for powerful people of the government. And ambassador was used more as an image that you ought to be from a very powerful background. You would either be a minister or from the government to be able to use this car. So if there was a black ambassador, it had to be of a military officer. If you were actually using a black ambassador, you would be collector of some city or a district, you know. So ambassador was more a car used as a powerful image to go around. But ambassador car today, if it's remodeled and designed and with new technology put in it, with all its comforts added, can become a better car. It is just that it has vanished from the roads because cars better than ambassadors are now available. So I think the government itself should be considering buying better cars other than ambassadors, which they used to buy. And the people who used to manufacture ambassadors have stopped manufacturing cars because I think they realized that something better is going around. Yeah? So I guess the fastest changing model in the car industry is what improves their sales figures. Okay, so I think design is directly related to the successful sale of the cars. And I think this is where you ought to understand. So if ambassador has to be brought back, it has to be brought back by change of design. Yeah. And I think we should have one exercise where designers should be invited as part of the competition to change the image of the ambassador and give them a better design.
Wonderful idea, sir. Wonderful idea. And I hope, Ganesha, that answers your questions. Sir, we are getting tremendous response. People are thanking you for the information, and we are getting flooded with the questions also. So I'll again pick up one question from the attendees before I come to my questions. Pranav Patil is asking, I want to ask you a question, and this is a very insightful question. I want to ask you a question, sir, that in past times, there is no technology like today. But people designed very interesting structures like Pyramid of Giza.
Right.
Can you please explain the functions and technologies that impacts on these structures?
Yeah. You see, that's a very interesting question. You know, the traditional technology has to be respected. And this is what happened in pyramids. But I would like you to understand that every time anything was designed, whether it be a temple or a mosque or any place of worship, it was designed with respect to a very thoughtful requirement. So if mosque has got a central courtyard in it, it is because everybody believed in the worship of reading namaz coming together. Okay. So there has been a reason for every aspect of design in any structure. There was a very strong reason for pyramid for it to be designed. You all know that in Egypt, there was the north-south axis and the east-west axis. The east-west axis was the sun, and the north-south axis was the river Nile. And pyramid was actually designed to follow this. The east-west sun actually designed its orientation, and the position of pyramid was on one side of the river Nile to take care of the dead. It is actually a tomb. Pyramid is actually a tomb. And this was built for the Pharaoh, the king, who himself called him as God. He was God as well as the king. And actually in Egyptian society, everybody was busy building their tomb. You know why? It was because of this very strong belief that your life actually begins after your death. While you are living on this earth, this is a very temporary phase of your life. It is only when your life begins after death that you have to build an abode for yourself, and therefore pyramids were built in such a magnificent and a sensational way that after you're dead, you can't do anything about it. So you should do something that lasts as long as 3,000 years, and therefore pyramids. Now, pyramid style of making was related directly to the sandstone being able to be kept on top of each other. But it also had a very sensible sign of doing a structure with stability. Pyramid is considered to be the most stable structure, and the angle at which it has been designed represents a certain geometry. Okay, but I can actually tell you more detail of it. The Egyptians actually created a pyramid out of the sense of mathematics and geometry. The ratio of the height of the pyramid to its base is in golden section. The point at which Pharaoh's dead body is kept is also 1/3, 2/3 ratio. So I guess the technology and the traditional wisdom of the people then has to be respected if you find out how it has been constructed. But they were not behind. They were not old. They were right for their time. And sometimes I feel they were ahead of our times. So I guess pyramid was more an imagery symbolism of power, and also to take care of their king, who after his death would not be able to be shown as mammoth or as powerful as he was, like the architecture. So architecture was used as an expression to not only show power, but also to show how great he was. Yeah. Have I been able to get where you have been trying to?
Yes, yes, absolutely, sir. Absolutely, absolutely. A lot of information pouring in. Sir, Prachi Chogle is asking how, this is quite a question which is basically, she's quite concerned on UX and UI designing sector. Now she is right. Concerned that the designs are repetitive everywhere, right. Whether it's in mobile or in web application. So how do you get the growth? How do you perceive the growth? How do you visualize the growth?
See, I think to be able to visualize a pattern, you have to design a basic unit. You should be able to design a basic unit in such a way that if it is repeated, it causes pleasing impact to your eye. If you, by creating a geometrical pattern, end up by creating many patterns out of it and are not able to build it, then you are unsuccessful. So I guess once you are able to design a basic unit which you wish to repeat, then you have to repeat it also in a certain way. You know, if you look at the most beautiful structure called Taj Mahal today, 1/4 of the Taj Mahal in plan, in design, is repeated the other 3 times on the other 3 sides. So minaret is actually a repetition. Okay, one minaret you have to design, but how you place all the 4 minarets, how you place all the 4 spaces around the central dome is an art. So even by being able to design one unit the right way, assembling it, designing it together requires another art. And design is nothing but multiple thought process, multiple entanglement of design units to end up with a project or we end up with a product that is pleasing to the eye. I have been told by many people that, you know, whenever designers are solving any problem, they only think of finding a solution to solve the problem. But after they have found a solution, and if it is not beautiful, they know it is wrong. They try again. They find another solution, which has to be beautiful. So design is not only repetitive in thought, it is also repetitive in design itself. So I guess designers have to live with this repetitive aspect of thinking until they decide to stop, until they think whatever they have been able to design is pleasing to their eye. Thereby, their level of satisfaction brings joy to everybody being able to see it.
Sure, sir. I think she is more confident. Sir, we are getting a lot of acknowledgement. I would read one of them from Elsie. Sure. Now, Elsie is writing, sir, you changed the perspective of design. Now I have understood more about the meaning of design. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
So thank you, Elsie, for attending. So we will move on to the next question. And this time I'll take my question.
Sure.
And my question is, sir, does it impact a child's growth if the university is located at remote location and not in a prominent city?
See, you mean to say the learning quest decreases if it is not in a city? Is that what you are trying to
yes,
ask?
Yes, maybe. Yes.
Sir, I think if you want to learn, it does not matter where you are now. Under the present conditions of the world development, under the global technology developing to this level, where entire world is coming together as a global village, even to fight pandemic like COVID, it actually really does not matter where you are. As long as you are connected digitally by the internet, as long as you are connected by the world of telecommunication by satellite, I guess what does not matter is where you are. But what matters generally in any school of design is the kind of teachers available for you to learn design from, the kind of practitioners, the kind of industry institute partnership that the institute has built, the kind of friends you make, the kinds of peers who join you while learning design. Because design is a collaborative project. Design is something which you learn with others. It's a team project. And believe me, even teachers like me who have been teaching for the last 3 decades find learning when I'm teaching students, you know. So I guess place does not matter anymore. As long as the desire to learn is instilled in mind and heart, what matters is being able to think better. It is this leap of imagination that matters. It does not matter where you are. Okay. But at the same time, I think good health facility should be available. Other basic needs could be available. And transport needs are being met up with, I think. Health, hygiene, cleanliness is something that is required no matter where you are. But you can actually now do it from any place now. It doesn't matter, is what I feel. As a designer, we are always looking for a place which is silent, away from the mess, away from traffic jam, away from pollution. It only helps us think better, I guess.
And Avantika University is a perfect example for all these. Anyway, sir, my next question is again on what are your views on Avantika and its blended approach of design and engineering, which we call designering?
Oh, I think this is extremely exciting for any teacher. Imagine a person who has finished his mechanical engineering and he wants to blend his thought process to come out with a product by not only drawing it out, but also seeing it whether it works. So marrying design with engineering can give you wonderful industrial products. Like I told you earlier, industrial products were designed, but they were not up to a certain level appreciated. But when you marry engineering with design, we will have better designed industrial products. I would like you to know, you know, I basically teach in a campus called the Sir JJ School of Art in Bombay, which was actually the first institute of art and design, started in 1857. The name of Sir JJ School of Art was Sir JJ School of Art and Industry, where all the artists would actually come up with designs and give it for industry to manufacture them. Later on, the word industry lost its attachment to JJ School of Art as industrial development took place. But believe me, during the time when India was going through independence, our post-independence phase, a lot of work in industries were given by designers. And once the industries saw a huge production, they started increasing the quantity and they forgot the quality of design. And therefore, the refrigerators that were designed 50 years ago do not find a place today in the market. Today, the refrigerators and washing machines are designed better because they are out of an industrial design school. They are designed by engineers who are sensitized by art and therefore have become very good industrial designers. So I think your idea at Avantika to marry design with engineering is wonderful and good for the society.
Wonderful explanation, sir. Sir Shravani is asking, considering the present pandemic situation and the uncertainty all over the world, what is the future of design career?
Oh, design as a career is always full of ideas and full of opportunities. As a designer, if you do not know what to do, or as a designer, if you are thinking, what is my future, then something is wrong with your thinking. Designer is the most sought after professional. Okay? We tell architecture students in our school that you are in a profession with 0% unemployment. People are looking out for good architects. If you're a good designer, people will look for you. You don't have to look for anybody else. And the ratio of design to the number of people for its requirement is very low. So you will be always in demand. Okay. Today, people are getting to be aware of a design profession, a designed product. And people are now willing to even pay designers because, like I told you, they can relate to it. You will always find a better designed car or a better designed building will have a higher price to pay than an ordinary car design or an ordinary building to stay with. Okay? A better designed chair will fetch you a higher price than an ordinary chair. So I think the value of design and the designer is increasing day by day. And you are the most sought after profession. You're always in demand. And if a designer does not know what to do, then something is wrong with his education, is what I can say.
Okay, fine, sir. Sir, since we have limited time, I will pick up this last question. What are the ethical issues involved in design? Devaraju has asked this.
See, ethical issues are something that you should be able to produce in a design product which you believe in. You know, ethics would mean that something that will work. Anything that you design, if it stops working after 3 years, is a bad design. anything that you design is unrepairable, is bad design. But anything that you design and is sold in a market for a very high price, which stops working as a product, is unethical on your part, and it is an unethical design. So I suggest that any product that you design, if it's not durable, is unethical. All right. So you have to be able to take 5-6 factors in a design. One is economical. It has to be affordable. You should be able to design a bridge that does not fall down after 2 years and kill people. Unethical bridge design. There's nothing like unethical bridge design. Bridge, if designed, if fails after 3 years, is unethical practice. So I guess unethical design is related to designing a product that is durable, that stays for a longer time, and people have a sense of honesty and belief in it. Okay. If I buy a pen that does not break down after 6 months, then it is a better designed pen, you know. And any product that you design has to have value. There is difference between value, price, and cost. Price is what you pay for. Okay, value is what you get. And designers believe in value rather than price. So you have to understand this. The other unethical design is that your friend has designed a product and you put your name in that product as yours. That is unethical design. Anybody has a copyright to a designed product, and anybody coming in the way and saying that you added value to it and therefore now you have the authority of design of this product is unethical. So I guess unethical practices in design are not very well known, but sometimes when they are caught, they should be punished, I guess. You know, we are actually working now on the national policy of design. National Institute of Design is working on the design policy. You can actually see the national design policy on the website. It is a downloadable PDF document. The national design policy actually talks about unethical design also. So you could also read it. Yeah. Over to you, Amit.
Yeah. Sure, sir. And thank you very much for this enlightening session. Yes, thank you for your blessings also through your words of wisdom, specifically on the positive attitude, which you have mentioned during your presentation. Really grateful, sir. And thank you very much.
Thank you very much for inviting me, Amit. It is a great pleasure.
Thank you, sir. So, viewers, we will come on to our next round, which is a very quick round, wherein I will ask two more questions, which will again can bring you a gift voucher. The first question is, in terms of graphic design, what does CMYK stands for? I repeat, in terms of graphic design, what does CMYK stands for? Okay, I've started getting the responses. Yeah, that's right. Rupesh is right. Okay, I'm flooded with answers. Yes. Okay, no, it's not all colors. No, it's not either printing colors. Yes, that's right. That's right. I'll not mention the right answer though. Okay. Okay. Oh, I hope Vasu, who is our backend support, is noting down or saving all these responses so that we can get the winners out of these lists. The second question is, the term used for designing things, again, the term which is used for designing things so that people work more efficiently and safely. The next question for the gift voucher is, the term used for designing things so that people work more efficiently and safely. Yeah, I got the right answer. Absolutely, Shreya, bang on. Yes, 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 yeah, I got number of answers over here. Okay. So with this, I would like to end this session. Thank you very much for your participation. Next Wednesday, we'll be back with yet another powerful speaker under Avantika Connect. Stay tuned. Thank you very much.